It's good ho, magpa-credit kayo. It's but, okay? Ito yung mga bantayan ninyo. Okay, thank you very much po. I'll go back to the slide. To be very honest, no, yung accreditation, very simple lang. It's a set of checklists that you need to comply and then you will just sign a piece of paper. And that's it. You're done. Now, eto ho, what is that piece of paper? So, yung piece of paper, ang tawag ho dyan, is the performance commitment. So, merong checklist. No? Magpapakredit ka, punta ka kay PhilHealth, or you go, or utusan ninyo sino man. You just comply with the checklist, may mga requirements. And then you sign a document. That document is the performance commitment. So, what is that? Yung performance commitment ho, is a contract. That the moment na magpapirma ka dyan, okay, you are obligated to follow the rules of PhilHealth. May kontrata. Okay, now, it's like this. Yung performance commitment ho, so, lahat ng doktor dyan sa MC, accredited ng PhilHealth yan. Okay, 90% or almost or 100%. Name it, accredited dyan sila. So, lahat yan sila, kay pumirma sa performance commitment, it's this. What is in that performance commitment? Okay, mahabang discussion yan. Okay, I'll just get some important points there. So, in the performance commitment, okay, there are things there that state the following. Ito po, you promise to obey the rules, the laws, the policies, and issuances. So basically, merong rules, laws, policies, and issuances. Okay? The moment na pinirbahan mo yan, okay, ang kasunduan mo kay PhilHealth, okay PhilHealth, I promise na alamin ko yan. Okay? Now here's the thing. If you did not read the performance commitment, you are in trouble. Now, this is intended for the doctors who are already accredited. Sa CA, okay, I'm pretty sure 90% of them hindi binasa. That is why, okay, pag nagka-problema ho, okay, ang doktor ang unang masasagasaan. So, what if, okay, ito, may I know, okay, so nagjo-duty kayo sa Digos, may I know, okay, who among you is nagjo-duty rin sa Davao City or sa Davao del Norte. Okay? Type number one. Or even if nandoon ka, or naka-duty ka na ba dati sa Davao City, Davao del Norte, okay, may I know. Type number one if naka-duty ka na or nagjo-duty ka. Type number two if wala. Okay, thank you po. Okay, thank you po. Okay, thank you, Doc. So, we have three. Okay? So, okay, thank you ho. So basically, my assumption is baka some of you, okay, thank you po. Baka some of you nag-residente sa ano, Davao or whatever. Here's my, the reason I'm asking is this, okay? So kung nag-duty ka, or nakapag-duty ka sa Davao, or nakapag-training ka, it's like this. There are several doctors, okay? Specialist and subspecialist na kinasuhan ni PhilHealth dito sa Davao. And even sa sur, konti lang. Sa north, marami. Okay? So, kinasuhan, they are under investigation and some of them, cases have been filed. Multiple cases have been filed. Simply because okay, they failed to read and understand the performance commitment. Okay? Now, I'm not trying to scare you. Ang point ko lang is kung binasa nila ito ng maayos, okay, probably lesser ang problem. Why? Kasi ho, ganito ang nakasulat doon. What's written in the performance commitment is this. These are just parts or a portion of what's written. Ha? I read, understood, and I'm fully aware of the Republic Act 7875. Yung RA 7875, that is the PhilHealth law. IRR stands for Implementing Rules and Regulation. Okay? So I'm fully aware and they are practically understood the IRR granted to them. Okay? So, in reality ho, sa tagal ko sa PhilHealth, okay, I've been doing this for almost 2 decades. Okay? Itong claims processing, 2 dekada na ho ako dito. The truth is, okay, wala hong doktor na nagbasa na yan. Okay? Next, okay, may nakasulat pang ganito, I shall conduct myself strictly and faithfully in accordance to the Republic Act and the IRR. Okay? How? Okay? Nobody reads it, or probably only a few. Okay? How will that happen? Na how can the doctors, okay, in full honesty, they can do that if they did not read it? Okay? Next, may nakasulat, I shall abide with all the IRR memo, circular, advisory, special order, and the AO. AO stands for administrative order. Okay? That they will follow that. I shall abide with the policies, the administrative order, circulars, and policies of DOH. Diyos ko. Pati DOH, obligated kang basahin yan. Okay? Now the question is, are you really serious? Again, nobody reads it. Probably a few. So, ito po. I am fully aware and acknowledge that the accreditation is not a right, but it is a privilege. So, the next question is this, are you threatening me? Now, my point is this, ang nakasulat ho sa performance commitment is that pag pinirmahan mo yan, you're telling PhilHealth na kabisado mo yung rules ni PhilHealth. But in reality ho, okay, it does not happen. Because number one, the doctors never read the performance commitment. The doctors just sign it. Okay? Sunod, meron nakalagay doon sa pipirmahan ninyo, ha, that accreditation is not a right. It is a privilege. So they will accredit you. Okay? And they can easily take it away. So, privilege siya, hindi ho siya karapatan. They may give you the privilege, but they can also take it away. So, ito pa ang nakasulat, I unconditionally acknowledge. Okay? Isipin mo yung term, ha? I unconditionally acknowledge and agree that the non-adherence to the guidelines or any violation is a breach of performance commitment. So, unsa may pasabot, ana? Okay? Na nag-agree ka unconditionally. Na if you, okay, cannot follow the guidelines, PhilHealth can easily, okay, decide that that is a breach. Yung breach ho, violation of the performance commitment. And because of that violation, PhilHealth has the right, okay, PhilHealth, okay, discretionary ho sa kay PhilHealth to suspend you, to shorten the accreditation, or even to pre-terminate.